Ah yes, the joy of building your own website. I fondly remember the first time I built an actual website with a very cool, custom-made, but barely functional, calculator. I proudly sent the link off to all of my friends, fully expecting them to appreciate the fine art that I had created, only to hear them say they couldn't access the site. It didn't load, and it didn't work. Now, at the time, I had no idea what was happening, but if you want to avoid the same kind of traumatic experience that I suffered, you need to know how to monitor your site's performance, see when it's failing, and know exactly what the problem is. Now, there are a lot of tools out there that will tell you how your site is performing right now at this very instance. Some of these services are even free. They essentially give you a snapshot of your current site's performance, but if you want to manage and track the performance of your site over time, you should be using a monitoring tool with active testing. When developers talk about testing a site's performance, there are two ways to collect this data, from humans or from bots. When you collect data from real users, this is appropriately named real user monitoring. Real user monitoring collects data from real user sessions and reports back to you how the site is doing out there in the World Wide Web, with all the variables included. The second way to collect metrics from your site is to create scripts that simulate a user. Testing your site with scripts is called active testing or synthetic monitoring. For more on the difference between real user monitoring and synthetic monitoring, check out this video here. But let's go a little bit deeper into what synthetic monitoring is. Today, I'm using Sematext Synthetics as an example. Link for a free trial down in the description. But these features should apply to all synthetic monitoring tools. So what does a synthetic monitoring tool actually do? Synthetic monitoring tools test your site's performance by executing scripts that simulate an end user. These runs execute a script that simulates a user and reports back your site's performance to the monitoring system. This removes any variable or noise created by human input and purely tests your site as is. Synthetic monitoring tools can also run multiple scripts to simulate how real users would interact with your site. This includes actions such as clicking on different buttons, filling out forms, signing up for newsletters, and pretty much anything else that you want to test. Most of the free active testing services online will only run one pre-configured script on your site and report back the results. But if you want to automate this process or run your own scripts or track it over time, it's worth investing into a synthetic monitoring tool. So when choosing a synthetic monitoring tool, here are a few things that you should be looking for. Worldwide uptime monitoring. When you build a website, you want all of your visitors to have the same great experience regardless of where they are located. What might work well in Europe might not be working so well in America. And bad experience with your website's performance can lead to a high bounce rate. And high bounce rates can lower your ranking in Google, which can then lead to a loss in traffic and overall business, and it's just bad. To avoid this, make sure your website is up, available, and accessible regardless of where your clients are physically located. Root cause analysis. When something goes wrong, it's important to know exactly what caused that problem. A good synthetic monitoring tool should enable you to track down slow-loading resources regardless of their type and generate a full incident report when the run fails. Spending time manually searching for an issue should be an automated task with a decent synthetic tool. Even better, with the tool I'm using, Sematext Cloud, I can search and cross-reference these runs with my app's logs. This allows me to troubleshoot multiple aspects of my application and drill down deep into the issues in one centralized dashboard. But just make sure that your monitoring tool shows you exactly what went wrong and why it happened so you can solve these issues before your users experience them. Automated active runs with alerts. Not all synthetic runs are created equally. If you need to test a single resource in your site or test an entire user journey, you should be able to create custom active runs that do exactly that repetitively. It doesn't really help you if your site worked yesterday when you tried it, but today when your client uses it, it's not working. You need tests that run periodically so that you can always be informed if your site is up and running. And you need to be alerted when the run fails. Bonus points if your monitoring tool uses AI scripts to determine anomalies in your system's performance. API monitoring. APIs are essentially the way that two programs talk to each other. Without a fully functioning API, most applications or even entire websites will not work. Most monitoring tools only test your site and not the API, which is no good. You need to ensure that your synthetic monitoring tool is testing the availability of your website's API, regardless of if they are yours or a third party's API. Make sure your tool is constantly checking the availability of your APIs so you know if they are performing as they should. Pricing. Synthetic monitoring is an invaluable tool for developers, but it should be coupled with real user monitoring tools. Don't pay an arm and a leg for two separate tools. It's best if your solution offers both real user monitoring and synthetic monitoring in one place. This is why we created Sematext Cloud. We wanted to provide a full stack observability and monitoring tool with an advanced alerting system at a competitive price. And we did just that. Check it out for free in the link down below. If you're interested in learning more about any of these topics, check out our YouTube channel where you can learn more about DevOps and site management and a heck of a lot more. Like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Make sure you keep monitoring, everybody.